Let's take 63 and divide it by 35. So the first thing that we might say is, okay, well, 35 doesn't go into 6. It does go into 63. It goes into 63 one time, because 2 times 35 is 70, so that's too big. So it goes one time. So let me write that. It goes one time. 1 times 35 is 35. And then if we were to subtract, and we can regroup up here, we can take a 10 from the 60, so it becomes a 50. Give that 10 to the 3, so it becomes a 13. 13 minus 5 is 8. 5 minus 3 is 2. So you could just say, hey, 63 divided by 35. Let me write this. You could say 63 divided by 35 is equal to 1 remainder 28. 1 remainder 28. But this isn't so satisfying. We know that the real answer is going to be 1 point something something something. So what I want to do is keep dividing. I want to divide this thing completely and see what type of a decimal I actually get. And to do that, I essentially have to add a decimal here and then just keep bringing down decimal places to the right of the decimal. So 63 is the exact same thing as 63.0, and I could add as many zeros as I might want to add here. So what we could do is we just make sure that this decimal is right over there, is we can now bring down a zero from the tens place right over here, and you bring down that zero, and now we ask ourselves, how many times does 35 go into 280? And as always, this is a bit of an art when you're dividing a two-digit number into a three-digit number. So let's see, it's definitely going to be, let's see, if I were to say, so 40 goes into 280 7 times, 30 goes into 280 about, it goes about 9 times. So it's going to be between 7 and 9. So let's try 8. So let's see what 35 times 8 is. 35 times 8, 5 times 8 is 40. 3 times 8 is 24, plus 4 is 28. So it actually works out perfectly. So 35 goes into 280 exactly 8 times. 8 times 5, we already figured it out. 8 times 35 is exactly 280, and we don't have any remainder now. So we don't have to bring down any more of these zeros. So now we know exactly that 63 divided by 35 is equal to exactly 1.8.